Let's start, guys. Today we'll do something different. We won't be singing any song with the Holy Spirit. How many of you all have got the gift of tongues? Anybody put your hand up? How many of you have got the gift of tongues? Can you please put your hand up? Okay, the others who do not have the gift of tongues, you can go on praising in your own language. Praise Jesus, thank you, Jesus. Can you do that?
Yes.
Yes, but I want everybody's mouth open and praising. We will just pray in the Spirit for all of us that come here to worship in spirit and in truth.
Amen.
So we will be singing, praying in the Spirit, because that's a language the devil does not understand. A bit. Only God understands. And as we open the floodgates of heaven in our midst tonight, we will be all be singing as the music will play. Go into time of just praising God in your own language. If you have the gift of tongues, use it and praise God in what the Holy Spirit now means. Right? So let's sign ourselves in the preparation prayer and then we pray in the Spirit. By the sign of the cross, the Lord in our hands, the Lord I see in the name of God, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Lord Jesus, by faith in your hands, and I'll drink your most precious blood and sprinkle it over myself and my family right from the ground.
And all that is not like
it. to praise God, we start with the whole thing. Now since you're writing and praise God with us as light, we sing the song. The song is quite simple. Sing it the first time, we catch a tune. It has got everything that you and I need to praise God. We say He's the Messiah. You'll say Amen. Amen?
Amen.
He's a rolling lion of Judah.
Amen.
He is holy.
Amen.
He is Lord.
Amen.
He is our Redeemer.
Amen.
He is our Savior.
Amen.
He is our Healer.
Amen.
He is my Rock.
Amen.
He is my Power.
Amen.
He is my Shield.
Amen.
He is my Strong Tower.
Amen.
And He is holy.
Amen.
Jesus, 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 the Messiah. God. Amen.
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 Today's theme that David is going to share is that don't worry, the God provides everything. You believe that?
Yes.
The same God that provides for the release of the dazzlements and everything, do not even ask, He will provide for you and me in our lives. Don't even try to live in our lives. Having praised Jesus, let us come to His presence, we all need His presence, to worship Him. And as we sing along with the choirs and angels, Hallelujah, Hallelujah. For you alone, Lord, are holy, you are worthy. Let's sing to Jesus in spirit and in truth. We all come here to praise God, to worship Him. There is a choice that is ever given today, as there may be Sunday. Have you worshipped Jesus? Today we do not bring any of our petitions to Him. We just worship Him and let Him love us. For He knows the innermost pain of your heart and my heart. He knows exactly what you and I need this very moment. Just let me Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord God, for your great and mighty presence in our midst, Lord. Lord, we have to prepare to listen to your word. We ask that you, Lord, to make our ears receptive and attentive for your word is life and life to each one of us. Praise you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Let's all sit.
What are we to eat or what are we to drink? or what are we to wear? All these things the pagans see. Your Heavenly Father knows that you need them all. But seek first the kingdom of God and His righteousness, and all these things will be given to you. Do not worry about tomorrow. Tomorrow will take care of itself. Sufficient for a day is its own evil. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I would like to begin the reflection quoting on sister's personal experience. This sister was suffering from breathlessness, and the medicine that was given to her was not acting. It was causing palpitation in her. She then told the doctor, and doctor took her detailed history and changed the medicine. She would tell, she was saying, whenever I got the breathlessness attack, I would feel like I am like a fish out of water and would crave for oxygen or someone to help me breathe. Now I would like to read the extract from medicalnewstoday.com and correlate with that sister's personal example. Now it says, dyspnea. Dyspnea is a medical term for shortness of breath, which the sister was suffering. Sometimes described as air hunger. It is an uncomfortable feeling. Now, I just correlate this sister's example of air hunger. There were times when she felt as if she is like fish out of water whenever she got the breathlessness attack and would crave for oxygen or for someone to help her breathe. Medical News goes on to say, it is sometimes difficult to diagnose and treat dyspnea because there can be many different causes. Now this sentence, if I correlate with that sister's example, she went to the doctor for breathlessness, but the medicine she was given caused her palpitation because the first history which the doctor took, it was incomplete. She didn't really describe. She only told about her childhood breathlessness and he gave based on that. Then of course, when again he took the history and when she said about the current thing that she was going through, when he gave it, worked on her. Then medical news tells, it is a common problem. According to the Cleveland Clinic Center for Continuing Education, one in every four people who visit the doctor have dyspnea. Now coming to causes, what does the medical news tell? It tells, causes of dyspnea is not always directly related to individual's health. However, dyspnea usually relates to health problem. But dyspnea can be a sign of serious health issues. Acute dyspnea, that is short of breath, could be due to asthma, anxiety, pneumonia, and many other things are said in that. So now she was telling, when I went to the doctor and told that this medicine, it is causing me palpitation, he took the history and then he said it is because of anxiety. So here again, the medical news has said acute dyspnea could be due to asthma or anxiety and many other things. Now what does the word of God tell us about going to doctor? Sirach 38, chapter 38, verse 1 and 2 tell us, honor a physician with the honor due to him, according to your need of him, for the Lord created him. For healing comes from the Most High, and he will receive a gift from the King. So this sister faithfully and sincerely did see medical intervention. What does the scripture speak on anxiety? let's see what the Word of God has to tell us on this subject. Jeremiah chapter 1 verse 5 tells, "Before I found you in the womb, I knew you. Before you were born, I set you apart. I appointed you as a prophet to the nations." And Psalm 139 verse 13 tells, "For you created my inmost being. You knit me together in my mother's womb." The God who has formed our innermost being, who has knit us in our mother's womb, who knew us through and through, even before we are born, this omniscient God, all-knowing God, He tells us repeatedly through His word. Matthew chapter 6 verses 26 to 34 we just read before we began the reflection. Verse 26, "Are you not more important than they?" They here refers to the birds. And verse 30, "If God so clothes the grass of the field which grows today and is thrown into our oven tomorrow, will He not much more provide for you, O you of little faith? So do not worry and say, 'What are we to eat, drink, wear?' All these things pagans see. Your heavenly Father knows that you need them all." Philippians 4:6-7 tells, "Have no anxiety at all, but in everything, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, make your requests known to God. Then the peace of God that surpasses all understanding will guard your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus." Isaiah chapter 49 verse 16 says, "See, upon the palms of my hands I have written your name." We may already be aware of these verses and many more verses. Yet, when the storm hits our life, we tend to forget what God has told us and we give in to anxiety. How can we stay away from anxiety? Isaiah chapter 26 verse 4 tells, "Trust in the Lord forever, for the Lord is an eternal rock." 1 Thessalonians chapter 5 verse 17 tells, "Pray without ceasing." Whenever we are in crisis, my dear brothers and sisters, always remember this scripture. 1 Thessalonians verse chapter 5 verse 17, "Pray without ceasing." It really helps, it really works. And James chapter 1 verse 6 and 7 tells, "But you should ask in faith, not doubting. For the one who doubts is like a wave of the sea that is driven and tossed about by the wind. For that person must not suppose that he will receive anything from the Lord." It's a clear-cut message for us. If we are doubting, then we cannot expect anything from the Lord. Speak positive. Colossians chapter 3 verse 16 says, "Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly, as in all wisdom you teach and admonish one another, singing psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs with gratitude in your hearts to God." Here I just share a short personal testimony. While I was preparing for this sharing, I'm actually basically an executive role person. And maybe that is the reason God put in my mind speak on anxiety. Okay? Thursday, as usual, I was just chatting with my son and he kept calling me. Normally, he doesn't phone, you know, constantly. And it is not getting connected, it is getting disconnected, and then I began as if something serious, has anything serious happened. Then I told, I asked my son through WhatsApp, shall I call you using the card? Because your mind is not getting. Then what happened? Then he sent having fever and 102.5. I said, my God, 102.5, all these years, from the time he has gone down, except for chicken pox, he has never got fever, and why now? So then I am asking, I am giving all instructions, go to doctor, this, and then I am telling, do you want me to come down? I am ready to come down right now. And then he says, no, mama, no need, I will manage. And then immediately I sent a message, my sister is next to door. I told, everything is having fever, as in when you get time, please check on it. And then I said, Lord, forgive me if I have become anxious, and then speak positive. I said, Elden is fine, he is not having fever, God has blessed him with good health, he is perfectly fine, all things are good with him. Elden is fine, God has blessed him with good health, all things are fine. I kept on saying that, because every time you know, speak positive, I said, let me practice myself first. And I kept on practicing. And then he went to doctor in the evening, and this was around 4 o'clock. 5 o'clock he was in the clinic, and 6 o'clock, 7 o'clock my sister went and saw him, and then she WhatsApped me saying, he has no fever, he is perfectly fine. I said, praise God. How praise God. So, speaking positive does help. Where is 102.5? I remember son and myself had gone to my brother's son's birthday celebration, 102.5. My brother's wife giving sponge after sponge for a very long time. Birthday celebration, and that same child suddenly fever that day and sponge. I said, my God, I am not there to sponge my son. But there is no need of a mother. God Almighty was there. He sponged, he did everything by himself and took away the fever. All glory to God. So this is how the Lord works, and we trust in him and speak positive. 1 Peter and Colossians 3:15 says, let the peace of Christ control your hearts. We must allow the peace of Christ to control our hearts. Never give in to anxiety. 1 Peter 5:6-7 says, so humble yourself under the mighty hand of God, that he may exalt you in due time. Cast all your worries upon him, because he cares for you. The moment you hear or see something unpleasant, or you think will have negative effect on our mind, what we must keep on saying is, praise you Jesus, thank you Jesus, praise you Jesus. So that whatever we have heard, something unpleasant, will not seep into our mind and body. We must give it to Jesus instantly. Just not allow it to get into us. Now then, next, what we should do? Keep hearing the word of God. What happens when we keep hearing the word of God? The Spirit of God works in a mysterious way. Okay, alright, each time I have a problem with discernment or that which causes anxiety, I tend to get into hearing the word of God. Like, for example, meaning when we hear the word of God, there will be a word connected to your current situation that you are going through. Okay, for example, last week message during the homily here, I don't know that priest's name, he is new for me. I know Father Celestine, Father John, and God's priest. Yeah, Father Thomas. Okay, during the homily, the one word, like, you know, caught my, all the word, this homily was very, but one pierced my heart. Action without reward. Okay, that, because of late I'm going through one thing with what the Lord wants me to do and keeping on asking, like, you know, in the spiritual realm. So here is, like, you know, that, and this action without, it's not just when I came here for a couple of months, even back home, each time I heard, whatever you do to the least of our brothers and sisters, you will do it unto me. So like that, many things I've been hearing. And then yesterday's and today's message, tolerate one another. Because my profession, my current profession is teaching. Okay, and many a times it would be very difficult for me to tolerate it. I would say, Lord, because I have children. Okay, so then it could be tolerate one another. I say, Lord, this is a message for me. Okay. And then while I was learning driving, I was having a very difficult time. Especially I had a clutch problem and the fear would grip me and I would not let go of the vehicle. And then I went for my prayer meeting there, and then the preacher was preaching sound and unsound mind. Because I was going through that phase, should I quit learning, then sound and unsound mind. And then there was a message for me. I said, okay, I will exercise what I did when I was learning two-wheeler. What I was doing for two-wheeler was, I kept on proclaiming the, confessing the word of God. I can do all things through Christ, Christ Jesus, okay, that strengthens me. And then another word of God, God can do exceedingly abundantly more than anything you can ask for. So like that, many verses I kept on after 2 months. Like, you know, people will laugh at me when I say, for two full months, every day I was going for that two-wheeler practice. Because instructor showed one technique, and that technique I was using with the practice, and I kept on. Finally, suddenly, because I kept on confessing towards the end now, the spirit of God took control. I did not know, without my knowledge, I let go. And I got the hang of it. So, hearing the word, what I mean to say, keep on hearing the word of God. It helps you in a situation. It becomes, sometimes it helps you in discernment and becomes a guideline for your day-to-day affairs. Romans 10:17 says, thus faith comes from what is heard, and what is heard comes through the word of Christ. So hearing the word of God builds your faith. Now most of all, this passage I will just run through because I am running out of time. Jeremiah 29:11 says, for I know that the plans I have in mind for you, says the Lord. Plans for your welfare, not for woe. Plans to give you a future full of hope. Acts 16:6-7. We read, and they went to the region of Phrygia and Galatia, having been forbidden by the Holy Spirit to speak the word in Asia. And when they had come opposite Mysia, they attempted to go into Bithynia. But the Spirit of Jesus did not allow them. See, sometimes when we pray, if our prayers are not answered, it is not just lack of faith or doubt. But sometimes it can happen that God doesn't answer our prayers for our good. I'll give you an example. Where my sister told her testimony. She was recruited. She got an offer to go to USA. She was selected and all. And she told the priest about the selection. The priest prayed for this intention, and he told his sister, do not go. Don't accept this, do not go. And then his sister said, my brothers and sisters, if I had gone, my posting was in World Trade Center. And this, she got the appointment before that incident took place. And through that priest, she was saved. So sometimes if our prayers are not answered or something doesn't happen, we should not get disturbed. God has this wonderful plan for us, and He wants to save us from something dangerous that could happen ahead. If we check in healthline.com, it is not just breathlessness, you know, that can cause due to anxiety. There are a lot of effects because of anxiety on central nervous system, respiratory system, cardiovascular system, excretory and digestive system and many more. Medical science gives us all this information after thorough study. Okay, but our good Lord, who is omniscient, all knowing, who knew us even before we are born, He cautions us time and again, do not be anxious. But how could He caution us, and why does He caution us? Because He is all knowing God. Therefore, my dear brothers and sisters, let us at all times be in communion with God and keep surrendering ourselves to God every moment of our life. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Let's bow down and for a short prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank You for speaking to us. May Your word take root in us. Help us to be in close communion with You all the time and keep surrendering to You every detail of our life. Help us to be doers of the word of God and not just hearers of the word of God. Isaiah 30 verse 18 tells us, "For the Lord is a God of justice. Blessed are all who wait for Him." Help us, Lord, to wait for You and allow Your plans to manifest in our lives. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
We praise and thank God for using Brother Alan to lead us in praise, worship, and Sister Idel to share the word of God this evening. We thank God for His mighty presence here in our midst and showering us all with His special blessings and graces. Let us give God all the glory with a mighty applause. We shall now pass the love offering bag for support. Thank you for your generosity. Announcements. Fasting intentions for the economic conditions and job situations to improve in Oman and everywhere. For the Catholic Church to stand strong through all the scandals and persecution it is currently facing. Prayer request for all the sick and especially those patients in hospitals visited by the healing ministry. For all the prayer requests that we receive in our prophetic warriors group. Our next prayer meeting will be on Sunday, 7th October in the parish hall here from 8:30 p.m. to 9:30 p.m. I will do the praise and worship, my dear brothers and sisters, and Brother Neville will be sharing the word of God. Kindly keep us and our families in your prayers. There's a special announcement. As we have done before, a rosary near the basketball court, we plan to have tomorrow, starting 1st of October, for the whole month. We will join together and pray the rosary after 7:15 p.m. Mass at the basketball court. You are all invited to attend, my dear brothers and sisters. And this rosary will also bring peace in our hearts and bring secure our job situations, and also secure the whole world which is in turmoil. The whole world, especially you have seen what happened to Indonesia. So let us if you can spare a moment, it's a time of sacrifice. I know that all may not be able to make it, but if you can make it, even if it is not daily, come. It only takes about maximum 15 minutes for the rosary. Some important news now, which we have already informed to you by email this morning. Brother Neville could not be here because he is attending another meeting. We request the core team, Brother Alan, Alan Gale, Joe, Sister Asha is here, Sister Gracie, Brother Jude, Brother Anil, Sister Philomena, and Brother Ishmael to kindly come forward. I don't say brother, sister for these youngsters, so I like they are like a little joke. So,
praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Take their time and sacrifice their efforts to be in the ministries and work for the glory of God. We do not have Brother Neville here, who heads the prayer group as a servant leader, and Sister Shalini, myself, and Brother Alan as the 14 members and the ministers. Sister Asha was the intercessory minister, and due to her personal reasons, has requested the core team to relieve her from the intercessory minister. So we would like to thank Sister Asha, who is not present here, for leading the intercessory ministry so beautifully and helping us Saturday after Saturday to come and put our petitions and give glory to God. We thank Sister Asha and pray to God that God will bless Sister Asha and her family, and especially her daughter Sharon. We also thank Sister Philomena, who was leading the healing ministry. Sister Philomena, we are from the OG. We want to thank you for the wonderful job you are doing in the healing ministry. And for all the efforts you have taken in this ministry and led the ministry so well. Every Friday after Friday, going and ministering the sick patients in the Royal Hospital, and also sending the prayer request to the prophetic warriors and praying for each of the patients. We thank you, Sister Philomena, as she takes on the new role of the intercessory ministry from Sister Asha, who she has willingly accepted to take the role of the intercessory ministry. So we thank you, Sister Philomena, for accepting the role of the intercessory minister, and we ask God's blessings upon you and your family, and God will take care of you as you have led the healing ministry so beautifully, and it is interrelated, and definitely God will give you the strength and courage to lead the intercessory ministries well. And we also have Brother Ismail, who is one of the senior members in the healing ministry, and he will be taking over from Sister Philomena as the healing minister. We also thank you, Brother, for accepting our invitation from the core team without hesitating for the glory of God. And we know that you will handle the healing ministry so beautifully that God has given you the gifts as you are in this ministry for so many years and in going along with the healing ministry. And there are also the elders who are there who will definitely help you out and you will do well. Dear brothers and sisters, we all stand and bless Sister Philomena, Sister, and Brother Ismail. We all raise our hands and we'll pray in tongues so that God will bless them, anoint them powerfully in these ministries so that they will proclaim the word of God and help them that they will perform beautifully in this ministry and give all glory to God. Hallelujah, 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 bless their families, bless their children, bless their workplaces. Help them, Lord Jesus. Please, Lord God, bless all that what they do, Lord Jesus. And thank you, Lord Jesus, for taking this ministry for Philomena and Ismail, Lord Jesus, that they are being accepted, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Jesus, thank you, Lord Jesus, for all the precious moments like this, Lord Jesus, as we are gathered as one family to glorify your name, O Lord Jesus. We thank you, Lord Jesus, for anointing these two members of our ministry, Lord Jesus, Brother Ismail for the healing ministry, Lord Jesus, and Sister Philomena for the intercessory ministry, Lord Jesus. And with these two members of ours, Lord Jesus, you are strengthening the ministry and the ministry of hope, Lord Jesus. And you will help them, Lord Jesus, to take on their roles and walk, Lord Jesus, with the crosses that they are going to take over, Lord Jesus. And we all, God, children, say,
Amen.
Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Good night, and God bless.